I believe that fusion energy can contribute very significantly to climate change in the future. Right now, there is not so many options. There is the renewable energies, which is indeed the energy from the sun, which is precisely fusion energy. But the sun is far away, and we could not control the sun. The sun shines from every day, but during the night, it does not shine. And so we have to find a complementary option. Complementary option so far is mainly fossil fuel. And as you know, fossil fuel releases a lot of greenhouse gas emissions, which are spoiling the functioning of the planet. We need very soon to reduce drastically our consumption of fossil fuel. So how could we substitute fossil fuel? Clearly, you have nuclear energy. And there is two options. The option of fusion, hydrogen fusion, ITER is trying to develop, and the option of fission. Fission is very well known, is the transformation of uranium now, okay, in order to get energy. Mm-hmm. There is some drawback with fission, as you know, due to security issues, as well as the waste management. But it is a reasonable option as long as we have not found an alternate option. Mm-hmm. And precisely, hydrogen fusion could be an alternate option for long-term climate change fighting. Mm-hmm. Why? Because there is enough raw material on Earth for millions of years, which is very well distributed in the world in such a way that we could avoid even competition between the various countries. Second, it is intrinsically safe. There is no risk of a runaway of a facility which will produce hydrogen fusion the way we are producing with magnetic forces. There is not at all greenhouse gas emission. Okay, no impact on the climate, no impact on the environment, since you are producing only helium, which is a gas which is not chemically active, neither radioactive. So it looks like a dream, but I do believe that this dream could come true through the large ITER project Korea is associated with six other large members in order to make this demonstration as soon as possible. As you know, many often the real breakthrough takes time, and we have to be patient. Mm-hmm. Beyond that, tokamak, the technology we are using, okay, which means a magnetic tor, has been explored during now maybe 50, 60 years. A lot of tokamak has been built in the world of the order of 120, including some in Korea. Mm-hmm. And they all demonstrate that we could produce hydrogen fusion. I am really confident that if ITER is succeeding in his mission, which is to demonstrate the feasibility of hydrogen fusion, not only from a point of view of science, of engineering, but also from a point of view of industrial management and economy, I am really confident that all the 35 countries which are supporting ITER through the seven members will develop their own facility to produce hydrogen fusion. I'm sure you are aware the US have a plan for that. Korea has a plan for that, as well as China and Japan and Russia and Europe. All of them are now pushing us in order to demonstrate as soon as possible for them to be able to take advantage of all the accumulated knowledge and develop their own facilities. The industry will be invited by 2040 to consider this technology. And so my expectation is that before the middle of this century, the industry will be able to build some similar facility as ITER and to connect them to the electrical grid. You have to consider that by the mid of this century, maybe we will have found some way in order to reduce the fossil fuels, but it will not be sustainable technologies, and we need at this time absolutely an alternate technology in order to produce massive, fully controllable power to connect to the grid and substituting to the fossil fuels. We will have the hydrogen fusion technology for massive, fully controlled, safe technology without impact on the climate. The main cost will be the investment cost for the construction of the tokamak. The running cost is expected to be quite low because the quantity of fuels you need is quite reduced. Could you imagine that if you have a 1,000 megawatt power plant using, for example, coal or oil, you use per year of the order of 8 to 10 million of tons of fuels. In the case of hydrogen fusion, for getting the same energy, you will use 350 kilograms of hydrogen, very limited quantity. And so, you know, the raw material will be quite cheap. And so if this investment is lasting for long, and because these magnetic cages will be made of superconducting coils, not using any energy, it will be able to last for multiple decades. And so I do believe that it will be economically viable. Korea is a key partner of the ITER project. Korea has clearly demonstrated that it master the technology. They have excellent industry. Many of the components have been produced with high quality, on time, and at a very reasonable cost by Korean industry. So I am very confident that when ITER will have demonstrated the feasibility of hydrogen fusion to produce net energy, Korea will be in the front-running position in order to develop their own technology in their countries. I understand that Korea has no fossil fuel. Korea has a quite small land where it is difficult maybe to develop as much as it could be, solar panel, windmill, way to collect energy and blah, and so and so. So you will need absolutely a complementary way to produce energy. And Korea, with all the know-how they have demonstrated for the project ITER, will be in a leading position to develop this technology. The main interest of fusion energy is that it is intrinsically safe, which means that you could not have a runaway. At a given time, in the ITER facility, you have no more than 2 grams of hydrogen gas. 2 grams, very limited quantity of raw material. And you have no storage of energy. You have only a flux of energy. So as soon as any deviation from the nominal parameter of functioning will be observed, the reaction spontaneously stops. So the risk with the hydrogen fusion is nearly zero. Certainly you have some radioactive material. For example, one of the brand of hydrogen is tritium. Tritium is a radioactive gas, but the radioactivity of tritium is quite limited, and the danger of tritium has nothing to do with some of the fission product, which are the result of the current nuclear power plant. So I am quite confident that safety will be fully fulfilled according to the expectation of the society. So my belief is that once ITER will have been developed and fulfilled its mission, each country will contribute to build some facility, and they will maybe cooperate. For example, if the Korean industry is performing very well to manufacture some of the components, it will be maybe the possibility for them to contribute to the world market. But at the end, I guess each country will develop its own facilities.